Today we're going to take a step further by learning about the status reason fields. By the end of this tutorial, you will know exactly how to customize and use status reasons to add valuable context to your records, making them more informative and easier to manage. Here we have our model-driven app that we built in the previous videos, and we have a list of products. We also have the active and inactive products views, and as we can see, we have this column called status. If we go back to our solution, we can see our table in here. The table is called products, and inside it, we have the columns. If we explore the columns, we see that we have several columns in here. Some of them were created by me in the examples, but some of them were already in there. And one of them that was already in there is the status reason. So we have status and status reason. We have seen the status, but what's the status reason? Well, this is another column that's highly related to the status. And this column is here to help us specify the reason behind the current status of the record. For example, let's say we inactive one of the products, we don't want this product anymore. We could use the status reason to specify why this product was inactivated. For example, we could select discontinued or out of stock, or any other reason that we might have in our context. Now let's add this column to the views and to the form to see it working better. And then we are going to customize this column to add our own status. So let's go back to the table. So inside my solution, I have a solution called commercial system. The table is called products. And we have the views and the forms, as we already saw on previous videos. I'm going to the active products and the inactive products, and I'm going to add this status reason field. So I entered in the view, I'm clicking on it, it will appear in the view here, I will just keep in there, in the side of the status, save and publish. Once it's saved, I'm going to go back to the inactive products view, and I will do the same process. Now that's saved, I'm going to go back, select the inactive products, and I'm also going to insert the status reasons. So I clicked on it, it just appeared here, I'll just put, just reorganize to make it them in the same order, so status and status reason, save and publish. Okay, it's published. If I go back to my model driven and refresh it, they should reflect in the views already. See, now we have status reason in the active product and in the inactive product views. We can see that the status reason value has the same value as the status. It's not very useful so far. We are going to learn soon how to customize. But before doing that, I'm also going to go to the form and add this column to the form so I can change it in an easy way. Going back to the product table, I'm going to go to the forms, and we have this main form that we also learned previously. That's the form that's used to edit or create a record from the model-driven app. In this form, I'm going to add the status reason. So click on it, it will also appear in the form. Let's also add status, even though it's not necessary, because you can change the status using the button in the model-driven app to activate and deactivate the record. Now that I have status reason in the form, I'm going to save and publish, and our customizations are done. It's published, let's go back to our model-driven app and click on any of those products to see the form appearing here on the screen and seeing the column. It doesn't show maybe in the first time I open, but if I refresh a couple of times, it will be here. See, now we have status. I can change the status from here. And I have status reason. So for the inactive status, I have status reason inactive. For the active status, I have status reason active. But we want to add, for example, that the status reason for inactivating is out of stock, for example, or discontinued. Let's see how to do this now, but first I'm going to just save and close. Once I saved here, the status changed to inactive because I chose inactive. So I need to go to inactive products to see my products in here. And here is the status and the status reason. Okay, now I want to modify the options for the status reason. In order to modify the status reason options, we need to go to our table inside the solution and change the status reason column. We are already here in the table, so we went to the solutions, selected the table, went to the columns, and here we have status reason. If I click on it, I will be able to edit this column. Here we can see that this column has the type of choice, and a little bit down below, we have a drop down here where we select active and inactive. So we can create the options for when the record is active or for when the record is inactive. For example, let's go to inactive, and here we have the option called inactive. It's the same name as the status. But let's say I want to have other options. Let's say the product is discontinued. So I'm going to create a new choice and call it discontinued. Or the product can be out of stock and I might want to change its status to disabled so the users don't see in the app. Because in the next lessons, we're going to build a Canvas app for the customers to select the products they want to buy. And I don't want that to show in there, so I want to inactivate, but I want to explain why it's inactivated. So my peers, my colleagues in my company know why the product is not active. Let's add the new choice called out of stock. So we might temporarily deactivate this one, this product that's out of stock, wait for when we have stock and activate back. Okay, now we have these three options. Let's make the default option, the default choice to be out of stock. So if I disable, I mean it's out of stock. And then if I want to change to discontinued, I just go and change and click on save. Okay, so now we have three options for the inactive one. For the active, we have just the one option that's still in there, but you could add other options. Let's wait for it to save. And now that we have three status reasons for the deactivated products, we can go back to our model-driven app, refresh to reload the options, and let's try to change the status reason for this one that's deactivated. So I'm going to open it, just double-clicking on it, and I will go to the form. I cannot change the status reason here, actually, because it's deactivated. It doesn't let me change the status reason. Let him just activate back. Okay, I'll activate. I just clicked in the button in the top. Now I'll put the status reason to inactive, and then I will select why it's inactive. I'm going to select out of stock. Then I'm going to save and close. Now I can see the status reason for this one is out of stock. So that's why it's inactive. For this one, the second one that I had inactivated, I will click on it. Again, I cannot change the status reason, so I will click on activate. I will activate it. Then I can change the status reason, so change the status to inactive, and change the status reason to discontinued. Because this product is just a test, I will never sell it. It's just called Bill001. I created when I was creating the table. I will put discontinued, so I will just save and close. See, now I have two inactive products with different status reasons. I know why they were inactivated. Going back to the active products, let's just inactivate another one. Click select it, click on deactivate. And here in this pop-up, now I have the drop-down to choose what's the status reason. So it's appeared here automatically. And now it's very easy to select what's the status reason of this deactivation. Again, as we can see, by default, we have out of stock because I set in the table that this was going to be the default one. Then I can click on deactivate. It will deactivate so it doesn't show anymore in the active products view, as we saw in the previous video. And if I go to inactive products, the product will be here and the reason is out of stock. That's why it's inactive. I could go back and activate it again. Since I don't have different options here to activate, I didn't set different choices. It doesn't show the dropdown, but if it had, it would show here and I could select what's the reason to be activating back this product. So I'm just going to click on activate and it will go back to the active products. That's all for now. In the next video, we are going to show this list of products inside the custom app. We are going to create a canvas app that's going to be the beginning of our app that we are going to provide to the users who purchase our product so they can easily create purchase orders. Of course, we need to create more tables, but we are going to do the first draft creating a gallery of products inside of Canvas app to learn how to connect a Canvas app to a Dataverse table. See you in the next video.